In this video, we're going to talk about how to film coral fluorescence. We recently made a short film called Weather a Coral Nightmare, and in this video, we want to give you a short insight into how we filmed it during our night dives. What equipment do you need to film coral fluorescence? So the first thing you need is a camera, macro lens, and an underwater housing. There's a rule for coral fluorescence, and that is the closer you are, the nicer it gets. So my first go-to lens will always be a macro lens. You also need a tripod because you'll be filming long periods of time and you're going to speed them up later on to reveal the movement of the coral tentacles. Some corals move very slow and look very static until you speed them up. To actually see coral fluorescence during your night dives, you're going to need an essential piece of equipment, and that is blue lights. These blue lights have a wavelength of 450 nanometers, and that is a common standard for coral fluorescence. That's going to give you the best results. So I'm not going to go into scientific details here, but to understand how coral fluorescence works is you shine the blue lights at the corals. What's going to happen is they absorb the blue light and they're going to re-emit it in a different wavelength so that you can see it as coral fluorescence. If you have the option, I would always recommend two lights for more creative flexibility and for more light power. We use the 2 Keldan 8M with the blue module, and the great thing about the setup is that if you already have those lights, you don't need to get a whole new set of lights. You just need to get the blue modules, exchange them with the white ones, and you're ready to go. And you even have the dimming options. For the Keldan 4X and 8X, Keldan provides a blue filter that you can simply attach to the front of the light. It's going to convert the white light into 450 nanometers of blue light. Having said that, these filters are not as effective and as powerful as the blue modules, but it's a way cheaper alternative and definitely worth trying out, especially if you're new to coral fluorescence. So to really get the best out of coral fluorescence, you're going to need a yellow filter for your lens, a so-called barrier filter. What this filter does, it maximizes the coral fluorescence and reduces the amount of blue light in your image. So essentially it blocks the blue light in your image. You're going to see coral fluorescence without the filter, that will work, but it's not going to be as nice and the colors are not going to be as bright as with the yellow filter. So you use those filters to really unleash the beauty of coral fluorescence. You can buy yellow filters anywhere online or at your local camera store. There are different densities, different shades of yellow. My recommendation is just to get a few of them and see what works best for you and your camera. So the last piece of equipment that you need is a yellow visor for your mask. So when you're diving, you want to see what your camera is seeing, and you can find the corals that fluoresce when you're diving through the reef. But bear in mind that when you have the filter on your mask, you have to flip it off when you're looking at your LCD screen and recording, because it's going to filter out the light of your LCD screen as well. So when you get back to your computer, the footage might look totally different than you've seen it underwater. So just remember to flip off the filter and you'll be fine. And that's about it. There's a whole magical hidden world to explore in the reef. It's not only corals that fluoresce, you have all sorts of fish like the lizard, goat, scorpion fish, you have moray eels, crustaceans, fireworms. There's so many marine creatures that fluoresce. Keep your eyes just open at all times and you will find something exceptional to film.